But no man laid hands on him because his hour was not yet come. Does anybody know the power of that scripture? Jesus told his disciples, I send you forth. He said, I send you forth as sheep in the midst of wolves. He said, whatever you hear in your ear, you shout it at the top of the house. Whatever I tell you in secret, he said, you make it known. And then he said this, the very hairs on your head are numbered, and nothing by any means shall stop you. This is exactly what has been said here. And they would have taken him. They would have laid their hands on him. But his time had not yet come. This is why Jesus then told his disciples, therefore, you go forth and you be bold. Why is that? Because nobody can stop you or lay hands on you or interfere with you until your time comes.
Come on now.
Nothing can stop you until the appointed time. You have to fulfill, I feel, the virtue, the will of God in your life. So I encourage you to be bold, be strong, stand up, because nothing can come against you and stop you that will prosper except God allow it. Jesus said, the Bible said, they would come again. Now, on the night of the betrayal in the Garden of Gethsemane, they came and they went to gladly. And they looked at Jesus, and Jesus said, who do you come for? They said, we want Jesus. And to let them know that, to let everybody know that they didn't kill Jesus. He laid his life down. He said, if I lay it down, I'll take it back. Praise God. And he said, now, who do you want? We want Jesus. He said, here I am. And they fell down like they were dead. Get up. Jesus said again, who do you want? They said, we want Jesus. He says, here I am. And they fell down again. What was he letting them know? You got no power over me except to come from the book. I freely healed myself. And one of the men went to grab Jesus, and Peter took his sword and cut his ear off. Jesus took the ear and put it back on and said, let's go. And they looked at him. Now, why were they able to take him? Because it was his time. You see, you go forth with boldness. You be strong, because nothing can happen to you until the calendar that God has on your life says so. You understand what I'm saying?
Amen.
And if he says nothing will come your way as such, you be bold as a lion. He told Joshua to be strong and courageous. And if he would be strong and courageous, no one would be able to stand before him all the days of his life. Now you see why Joshua was so bold. Because he knew as long as he was strong and courageous and then turned to the right, to the left, and followed the laws of God as Moses did, he knew what God said. Nothing could stand before him. Jesus spoke bold because he knew that it was not time for his crucifixion. He knew it was not time for him to lay down his life. So he let it all out. And they went to get him, but they couldn't. They wanted to rise up, but they couldn't touch him. Because the word of God wouldn't let them. And the will of God and the word of God won't let anything touch you before the time. Good or bad. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Amen.
You be bold. Be strong for God. Because nothing by any means can hurt you except he allows it. And they couldn't touch it. And read.
And many of the people believed on him and said, when Christ cometh, will he do more miracles than these which this man have done? The Pharisees heard that the people murmured such things concerning him. And the Pharisees and the chief priests sent officers to take him. Then said Jesus unto them, yet a little while am I with you, and then I go unto him that sent me. Ye shall seek me and shall not find me, and where I am, thither you cannot come. Then said the Jews among themselves, whither will he go that we shall not find him? Will he go into the dispersed among the Gentiles and teach the Gentiles?
The Pharisees were upset as the people began to say amongst themselves, listen, not only do we hear this man, but we see his works. I wonder what people say about you. Not only do they hear you, but do they see your works? And in your words, do they glorify God? That's why the gospel is not with enticing words of men's wisdom. We don't want to hear how well you can speak, how articulate you are. Now, it may help, but what we do want to see is you demonstrate the words you just spoke.
That's right.
Yeah. We want to see you demonstrate all those fancy words and the dotting of the I and the crossing of the T. We want to see how well you can use that grammar and present the power of God.
Amen.
If you can't, we want to take a stuttering preacher who can demonstrate that a preacher that is eloquent got no power. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
We have a lot of sermon builders, a lot of preachers that are known to be powerful because they're good motivational teachers. But being motivated ain't going to get you into heaven. A lot of things you can be motivated about. You understand what I'm saying? Amen. Being a good motivational speaker is not going to put no devil on the run. Neither will it cause deliverance to come. You understand what I'm saying? So what Jesus did, not only did he speak, but he demonstrated. And this is what they said. Will anybody do more miracles than this? Has there been anyone that has demonstrated the kingdom of God than this? And the Pharisees sent officers to take him. Somebody say, make it plain.
Make it plain.
Thank you, sir. The religious world, the so-called church people, the people who claim to know God. It's a sad thing when you claim to know God, but you cannot recognize God and he's standing right in front of you.
Uh-oh.
I feel a virtue. Oh, I feel a virtue. It's amazing how so many people claim to know God, but don't know the doctrine, don't know his teaching. And in other parts of the scripture, Jesus said that they that know of God will know of my doctrine. They that know of God will know of the true teaching. And my sheep know my voice, and the voice of a stranger they shall flee from. The Pharisees, the highest order of the Jewish religion, sent guards to do what? Stop and shut down the anointing. You get so religious, you quench the spirit. You're so religious and caught up in your own frame of thinking, you miss God. And the Lord is sitting right there. You don't even see him. You don't even know it. Because you're so caught up in your own pride of religion and knowledge and your own holiness, which has gotten you nowhere. Jesus told the Pharisees, you have a key of knowledge. You don't enter in and you stop others from entering in. These are religious people who sit in Moses' seat. But in all their religion and all their knowledge, they could not accept the anointing. I feel virtue. You see, because they thought they knew more than God. They thought that the gospel and the way of the Lord was based upon their interpretations. And how many of you Pharisees, I didn't mean to say that. How many of you church folk quench the Holy Ghost? You block the anointing. You try to put it away. When Jeremiah was preaching, amen, by the power of God, what did they do? The king of Israel, what did they do? They locked him up. How many of us locked up the word of God? The truth is so painful to us, we can't stand it. We strike out in anger, in envy, in strife. You can tell the tree by the fruit of that. No man speaking by the Holy Ghost calls Jesus a curse. No man speaking by the Holy Ghost denies the word. This word has been around for 5,000 years. And we can hop and holler all we want to. It's going to be around for more than that. When we're gone, it's still going to stand. Men who think they know the will of God. Lord help me. Somebody said, why you say that?
Why you say that?
I say that because men, we think we know the will of God.
Right.
And we don't know ourselves.
That's right.
Did y'all hear me? You don't know yourselves. Our hearts are deceitfully wicked.
That's what it says.
My God. Lord, help us. Don't you know how real Jesus is? Ain't nothing new under the sun. The things that people say today against Christ, against the word, they've been saying it for years. No new arguments. Which means what? They've never been proven right. Same old questions. Paul wrote this. Who didn't write that? Who did this? This is not right. The same old question. Nothing new. You can go back, and when you read these things, you can go all the way back to the first, second, third century, all the way up. It's the same statements that the critics made, trying to put down the word of God. The same statements. for all these years. Why is that? Because they ain't never been proven. They cannot deny the power of God's word. Somebody say you want to talk about it?
You want to talk about it?
No, brother, you know what I'm saying? Live and die. Just live and die. My point is you can just tell what I'm saying. You think God's word ain't true? Get them. Live and die. You'll find out. God, he doesn't have to. The word of God stands strong. The word of God stands real. You see the seats that you sit around. I was talking to a young man. You see the chairs that you sit around. What's holding them up? The legs. If something were to come and cut those legs, everything in that chair would come down. If the word of God was destroyed, this whole earth would crumble. Because it's what's holding it up. It is what's holding it up. The stars would collide. The sun would burn the earth. The waters would flood everywhere. Why? Because it was the word that said God would not allow water to cover the whole earth again. It was the word that said he held the stone, he put the stars in space and hung them on nothing. It was the word that said the waves of the sea come so far and they don't go past the seashore because God tell them to come back. Is anybody hearing me? Amen. You take away that word that's upholding everything and we got nothing. Amen. We've got nothing. I feel the Holy Ghost. Read. So now you don't want to be more holier than thou. You don't want to be more holy than thou that you all got something to understand it, but yet you need deliverance yourself. And that goes for me and every preacher and every saint in here. You hear these preachers getting on the internet and stuff and making a mockery out of Christ, badgering each other, going against each other, and some of them make better sense than each other, but the truth of the matter is all of them, almost all of them are in error. Condemning themselves while they're condemning somebody else. I feel the virtue. Why is that? Because they that compare themselves amongst themselves is not
wise.
Wise. You don't get in your own group and declare yourself a scholar. You got all the wisdom. I feel the virtue. The Bible says, don't praise yourself, let another man praise you, because your neighbor will come and find you out. I feel the virtue. I feel a strong virtue. So you don't ever want to boast on what you know. Gnostics, secret knowledge. Is that right? You got more secrets than God, man. Because God said he wouldn't do nothing until he revealed it to his prophets.
That's what he said.
He speaks it to his prophets. And he's given us the understanding of all the mysteries of the kingdom. Anybody hearing me? I've been to many conventions where people get in the corner and they are against it. The group they're with, they have their differences, but instead of bringing it up, they get in the corner and they have their little, you know, statements. You know, man, I don't think this, and then everybody has their own interpretation and their own revelation, like they're super holy. And what's so sad, you got a lot of worldwide organizations that have done good for the, you know, for the name of Jesus, at least Paul said they preach, and as I study and I see, my heart is heavy. Because God doesn't play. When he says only few will be saved, only few will be saved. You have many people that say they are the apostle doctrine, but when you hear some of their teaching, my God, how long have they been in deception? So if you can understand the word of God, right in the Bible, please, thank God for that.
That's right.
Because all men have not faith, neither do they all have understanding. You say, church, say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Don't be a Pharisee. Being caught up in your own righteousness. Let God's word be true and every man a lie.